Yep.
It started off a bit gray, but now the sun has just popped out to join us. And look at this glorious green backdrop behind me. It's another scene out of The Sound of Music, and just gorgeous up here. Just vibrant green slopes on spilling down both sides of the valley. We've got a roar of a creek across down in the bottom. And here we're faced with a choice. We can go up to some smaller lakes under Beaujolais, or go to a large lake to camp overnight in between Beaujolais and Sockeye Horn. Here comes the rain.
Yeah.
What a unique little spot. I keep turning around to look back because the view just gets better the higher we get. And there's like, it's like Tarnsville around here. Tarns left, right, and center. Really beautiful. Point them out with your pole.
This one's not really that good.
What do you smell, Mies?
There's a tiny cup here that I want us to go with the pole. But, yeah, never noticed any wear and tear before that.
Okay.
See how well I repaired it.
Okay. That's promising.
Is delicious. Some Parmesan, some basil. Oh, the reflection on the water and everything.
Oh yeah.
I think we're near 2,000.
The peak is 24, so yeah,
I think we're around 2,000 meter. Maybe just under.
It's gonna be a cold night.
It doesn't quite feel like summer up here anymore. Once the sun went behind the ridge, it is quite chilly, you know. For the beginning of August, this is a unique experience to be really kind of underprepared for how cool it would be up here. I think we're near 2,000 meters and, you know, it's going to be a chilly night, but that's going to be no problem. I got a warm sleeping bag, so.
Gorgeous, but as like iPhone. Chances it's gonna suck. I'm not gonna even try.
That's where we're going this morning. Right there, follow this ridge up the slab to the summit of Beaujolais. Come on, girl.
Behind me here is the slab crux on the west ridge of Beaujolais. It doesn't look too bad. There's lots of features in the rock here. We're going to kind of follow the cracks. There is exposure as the slab drops away to our left and a cliff on the right, but we're going to stay right next to the corner of this slab and make our way up. This is going to be the spicy section of the ridge going up Beaujolais. I think it's going to be fun.
Your shirt matches those flowers.
After the slab, which we all got up safely, we now resume this blocky terrain, jumping up and down these boulders and blocks and steps to the summit.
What a view.
Not bad.
We're little minuscule humans jumping up these big blocks of rock.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Luc de la Montagne. Nous sommes sur la summit de Beaujolais Montagne. Et vin rouge, Beaujolais, sur la summit. We're going to drink this to celebrate. Cheers. We're on top of Beaujolais Peak. Brought a costume, because it's a, why not? This is Bouchard en aîné et fils.
Fils.
Add anything you'd like to say. Santé. Et la fromage. Gouda. Épicie. Et vin rouge. C'est parfait. C'est bon, n'est-ce pas?
Sure.
You like it?
Mm-hmm. Bouchard aîné et fils.
2020. Young girl.
This is a beautiful morning at this lake. We're gonna call it Gamay Lake because that's the kind of grape variety in Beaujolais. And look at the reflection of Tenkil Mountain in the lake. It's just absolutely beautiful this morning. What a fantastic reflection. My stove ran out of fuel, so for the last morning we're here, it's just gonna be iced cappuccinos. This is an instant cappuccino mix with cold water and snow. Let's see how it turns out. This is my first time trying it. Shaken, not stirred. Oh, that looks pretty good. Yeah, it does taste like an iced coffee. When it's summer, we drink iced coffees in the backcountry.
We're
We're now at the crux coming up Sockeye Horn, and it's just a bit of ledge scrambling and blocks. We need a couple hands, and it has some exposure down here to the south. So it looks like an enjoyable route here. We're almost to the top. We are on the summit of Sockeye Horn / Mystery Peak. This is a funny one because it has two names. And I prefer Sockeye Horn because sockeye salmon is one of my favorite fish. Such a vibrant, beautiful fish. And there are several mystery peaks. We're at 2,500 meters basically. And this was higher than Beaujolais Peak across the valley yesterday. This was another fun scramble, but I think it was a little bit easier than Beaujolais.
Yes. Beautiful day. It's amazing up here.
What do you think of the views?
Yeah, it's great. Successful day so far, but it's not a success till you're back at the car, so.
We're only 50% of the way.
Exactly. It was challenging, but it was manageable. Like, it was good.
We are now all packed up and leaving the lake. It's tough to leave this beautiful place, but we gotta move on and cover some distance to hike back out of here and get to the car. So what a gorgeous place to spend the afternoon in the sun under these beautiful peaks, but time to get out of here. We're here underneath this wave, just getting barreled. Whoop-a! Oh yeah. Getting barreled in the summertime under this snow wave behind us. Big wall of snow. Isn't that sweet?
I went sideways. Yeah.
think we get a bug situation here.
We do have a bug situation. Look at that glow. Yee-hoo! Look at those bugs.
We've now made it back to the truck after a really long hike out of here. About 15 kilometers, is that correct? 15?
Yes, 15.
15 kilometers, 10:30 p.m. So we were hiking out in the dark, under the stars. But at least it was cooler. What a day it's been.
It's gonna be a cold night.
Because we are around 2,000. We're near 2,000.
I think it's 24, so yeah.
I think we're around 2,000 meter, maybe just under.